So today we have a tutorial for a kit building, and it's a fuller chemistry plant, which is a quite a complex model with over 1200 parts. It's not as much as the model is complex, it's more you need to be very organized to do that. You will have to follow the manual very to the letter and cut the pieces only when you need them, otherwise forget it. The box is quite large and it has a quite thick manual with 30 pages, and there are a lot of different steps. You should start by checking that all the plastic pieces are included. It might happen that one got forgotten and then you can reorder it from Faller. It happened to me on a other kit, so I just ordered it and it was not a big deal. So, and since there are many different parts and they are on, you have several of the same plastic holder and some don't contain all parts, it's quite challenging to check that everything is here. But it took me like I think nearly 1 hour to check that everything was there and just to get an overview over all the parts and what you have and so. The best is just to tick off all the parts on the manual to see if you have it there. Yes, and it took me a long time to build that kit. It took me nearly 3 weeks, and I constructed every evening a little bit. But I painted a lot of the parts with the airbrush, so that took additional step, which took more time. So if you don't want to do that, it will take a little bit shorter, but your model is going to look very boring and very plasticky, which doesn't fit for something. It should be out of metal. So the first thing you do is you construct some apparatus which will come on the ground floor of the factory, and this contains of a lot of pipes and boilers, and I don't really know what it means to, so I will have my sister tell me what it is since she works in a chemistry plant. But first, you start by building this chimney, which will connect to the rest of the factory. I decided to glue everything together before I actually paint it, instead of painting everything, because it just sticks better without this paint everywhere. Otherwise, you have to make sure you don't paint where you glue. And the only thing I didn't put on directly were the cranks or the taps, because I wanted to have them red, so it would not go if they were on and I paint everything, so I mount them later. there are four of the plastic parts of this type. This is type number four. I have seen it so often. And you don't use all the pieces from all the four each. So, yeah, so it'd be, but for some you use all. So if you lose one, you're being screwed and you will, your construction might be halted. Here is the stuff finished mounted, but then I realize I cannot just put it together like in the manual, because it will, the problem will be that there is no ground plate for this model, so you have to make your own, and otherwise it will be impossible to carry it around, because as you see, I'm building it at home and not in the train room. So I decided to mount as many sub modules as possible. I'm gonna have everything ready. I will put it together on the my own ground plate. Here we see the construction of the building structure, which is supposed to be a steel structure painted in blue. I later spread it with some blue metallic color to give it a nicer look. And here you have to glue one part of that in, because they just couldn't produce it finished. So, and when you, while you're gluing that, the thing will not be very stable. It's just interlocks, and you will have to wait until the glue has completely cured. Otherwise, you cannot really continue. It just will wobble around. So make sure it's straight, and best is just to go and do something else and wait for the next day until the glue has completely cured. So here I'm gluing together the first floor, and it has four pieces, but I want to put LED lights. You can buy the follow lights, but they will cost you a fortune. So in the next step, I'm going to show you how I did the LED lighting. So I ordered a bunch of SMD LED, and it's not very simple to actually solder on them because they are very small, but I found a trick how to do that. I basically stick some masking tape on my working bench, and I put one which is sticking way upside, and there I just drop a couple of LEDs from the roll. And then I solder it one after the other. And because it sticks, it will not move around while soldering. And if you can even solder with quite a big soldering iron, because mine is not that great anymore. I need to change the tip, but I haven't found new ones yet. And as soon as you have soldered, if you do it correctly, then it will be strong enough that you can remove it from the tape just by dragging on the cable. And one thing is, you have to test all the time that you actually have connected all LEDs the correct way and that the cable actually holds, because a few times one of the middle cable just broke away, and by the way it's later mounted, it will be not possible to fix it. But it's very unlikely that one of the LED breaks unless you put too much voltage. When I'm done, I connected the cables to my follow transformer, which gives DC power, and I decided to have the resistor on the negative pole for all the LED I do, so later I know how to connect it. And then you can turn off, and because all the lights turn it on, I mean, and because all the LEDs are in series, you will need to put a certain voltage until they start to light. You will see it, it's just nothing, and then it goes on. It's not that it's broken. If you have one LED, it will start to light earlier. Yeah, to hold the LEDs on the plastic, I basically stick them down with some masking tape, and then I use a super glue to glue the cable. And I would use enough because you don't want to move them and put any stress on the cable. So wait until everything has cured before you continue, and check all the time that it actually still works. Then on the ground floor comes some kind of oven or machine which is supposed to do something warm. Yeah, that's what I look like a cement burner or something like that, but probably they just took parts I know they had in their inventory. So then I have to mount also the next floor, and it's like two half floors this time. And there I also put some LED so it lights the floor and you can actually see that oven or roaster or whatever it is. So, and the next step is to build this tanks, which are also put on the ground next to the plant. So here you see in the manual there where it's supposed to come later. So yeah, you have to be sure to take the right pieces again, because there are several of these round tanks which will be built. So, and one of the next submodules I have to build is this column, refraction column or tank. And I have built previously another one you could buy separately, so I can have two of these. So, and since I already done it before, it went a bit quicker. So you have to stick all the different pipes together to form the tank. And in the middle comes a small balcony. On the side comes a kind of pipe. So you have to put out the pipes number. It's the part in the set number 12. And there are like six or seven of these. And you are going to use quite most of the useful pipe pieces until the build is finished. As you see, I sprayed or airbrushed the tank so it gets a more metallic paint color you would usually find on one of these tanks in the real life. And you have to put that balcony where the ladder comes, and the ladder needs to be modified a little bit compared to when it comes straight from the plastic part. So here I put the tall balcony and I glue everything together. So when that's done, you can actually put all the ladders and the protection railing, which is around the ladder, which is only held by having glue on eight little points. So be sure to cure completely before it continues. And the two platforms, they have some kind of railing, and due to the form, you need to put it into two pieces, and it's a very fiddly stuff to put right. It could have been done a bit better, like bending some plastic or so, but at the end it works. You just have to wait until it has cured and do something else in the meantime. So here the pipe is mounted to the tank, but it's recommended not to glue everything. You have to be careful not to glue everything because you might need to turn the, let's say, T part later where the other tube comes to the correct position. So, and next sub module is this, I don't go, powder container, which comes on the side. It's basically out of two parts, and you have to use this bright blue plastic, which is only one which are like that. And I painted it also because I think it just didn't look right. So, and the next step is to build this huge tank, which has three of these huge wings and then one of the top modules. And the two of the top modules are used standalone later in some other steps. Just, I glued them and then I painted it also with some color. And next to the big tank, there comes a little tank which is connected with a pipe. So this one also had to be built and paint, because I find it easier when you can paint a lot of stuff at once, especially when you have to put some primer. So here I had taken a piece of wood and painted it gray like concrete. It's just a base. You probably need to put some more details like rest of plants, little walls, marks of the street. But I'm going to do that later because I can airbrush the stuff. So I pre-arrange all the modules I have. I had to find out where I want to drill a hole for the cable for the LED lighting. I also tested that the LED were still working and not any cables have been ripped away. After having plastered everything on the table and glued it with some wood glue, because it's wood and plastic, I glued on the first floor and put some weight to hold it down while it cures. Because the floor, it might not be completely straight, so you get, at least it will hold. And it was quite tricky to put this weights on the right place, and each was half a kilo and it held without a problem. So I let it there for a couple of hours and then it was okay. And I glued the oven on the first floor and connected with a pipe I had pre-made to the chimney there. work on the railing. I just keep them yellow, so it's okay. It could have been painted yellow, but you have to cut a lot of them, and you have to keep the parts over many, many pages. So after the railing has been put on, you can put the second floor, which is also made the same way with this kind of frame, which I have painted in advance. And also here, put the weight so it holds down while it cures. The next step is to put in the two floors where I had also mounted LEDs. It went quicker and quicker every time, but you still have to wait until the super glue has cured and everything holds. But like I said, you will never be able to change a LED later, because basically you would have to rip apart the complete model to get access to that floor, and all the tubing and piping have to be broken. Then again, the floor is put in place and some weight is added on the top so that it's held down while it cures. I'm using quite a lot of this glue, I thought, and there was one day I had glued so much I just felt bad in my apartment, so I had to air quite a lot, even if the ventilation and so was going on. So when everything is done, I glue this tank, which is in the front, also with some wood glue, and even if it's too much, it's going to dry clear. But as I said, I need to work on the ground because it's at the moment too clean. It needs to be more dirty. It's chemistry, so it will get black or some other colors. And after that, a new round of railing was announced. And yeah, this cutting and so is quite annoying, but otherwise I would have to make different lengths and so on. It would be way more expensive to make that kit. It already cost quite a lot. I paid nearly €120 for it. And I got a special price at my dealer because he bought it when the Norwegian kroner was way stronger compared to the euro, so I got a very good deal instead of ordering it new. On the next floor, I just skipped the LEDs because there is nothing under, and it makes it it attracts more to the view where there is actually something to see in the model. And here some more railing, and it was very fiddly and a quite frustrating work. Then more pipes were needed, so you had to find the pieces in this one, and at that point I had already used a lot of the parts, so you had to check on which one of the four the part is available. So basically it took me some time. I had to go through all four to find that it's only on the number four, that the part like number 455 was still available. I mounted all the parts, also pre-mounted them, and then I airbrushed them to get the correct pipe color to be seen as like metal and not just plastic pipes. So after everything has been cured and painted, it was time to mount everything together. Here I'm adding the last, some more piping on the side. It's quite confusing with the race. Here I add some more railing, and then come some struts for the upper floor of the factory. So here one more tank with some tubing. I have to find out what this factory actually does, because some of the piping actually doesn't make sense. Here the top floor has been added and there is some weight on it to cure it, and so it doesn't move while doing that. I use my soldering iron third arm to hold stuff while it cures. It's not the most practical, but it was the only thing I had under my hand, and it did the job. You just have to try it a couple of times until it's in the right configuration and everything is in the right position. So, and more piping was necessary, and that's to connect the column with the rest of the factory. So I just cut up all the pieces. By that time I knew exactly which number was which, how it looked like. So the next step was to build these stairs, which are on the side, and it was, let's say, one of the most impractical things to glue, because the way it was made, it was nearly impossible to hold the stuff in position while it cured, so it was not, it's not the most straight stairs, and I think the stairs are quite narrow compared to the height of the, but how it should be, it should be at least double as wide in reality. I don't think even one of these figurines will have place on it. So here you see the stairs on the bottom and the tubing where it fits. But since I'm wanting to have two of this column, I will have to make some more piping, but later more to that. So now about these big tanks which comes on the side, they also required a complicated piping, and this is a one part the big tanks, they don't have the number printed on the plastic, you have to find it in the manual. So here I have mounted all the pieces together and painted them with the airbrush, so I mount everything and then I can fix it together. So here I pre-position where the stuff should be, because there will be some kind of bridge from the factory to the main tank for maintenance reasons. So and you have to put this big pipe come between the two upper part of the tank which are on the bottom, and you have to wait until you glue the tube on the big tank so you can move it around. Then comes some more fine piping on the side. Basically I have my soldering third hand and hold it while it cures, and it's a small detail, you won't see it from where it will be because the factory will be like 1 meter away from the edge of the layout, so you won't really see all the smallest details, so we don't have to go crazy exact so people cannot put their nose in it. So after everything has been fitted, it's time to glue the tank to the bottom and then all the stuff together. Here I glue the tubing. And there is this fine tube which goes from the tank to the rest of the factory. So yeah, which also is something which doesn't really make sense from an engineering point of view. So and then here I add some more details which are in the plan, and this is some holder for that bridge which goes over. It was quite tricky to make that railing stick to the tank because it's not flat and the railing requires something flat, so maybe you should cut on the side a little bit to be able to bend it. And here comes some more tubing I had made. So I had pre-melded it and then airbrushed it. So I have to find it the right way because now everything is glued down. I think if you would just hold it like it's in the manual, it would not go very long and then everything would fall apart. It should deliver some kind of grand plate with that model. So, and with some remaining spare parts, I make some new tube to connect both columns together. So, I didn't have any straight parts anymore, only one, but not just long one, not short ones. But at the end, it just fitted. Technically, we could add some more parts. I think probably you can order some or get some more kits or so. So after everything was fitted, I just glued all the parts together and glued the columns to the grand plate with a lot of glue. So that's it, and after 3 weeks I finally had the factory running here with the lightning. It was not quite frustrating at some time because it just didn't come forward. And the factory is not finished. I have two more kits I can build. I need some kind of mechanism or apparatus, or I don't know what, to unload and load the car. We will stop right in front of it. And my sister remarked, I think it's a factory, you need some chemical plant, you need some R&D building. And I just realized that Follow is going to release a new building, which exactly fits as an R&D building next to it, and then there will come some kind of fence and a door which will open when a train comes with a servo. This one I have to scratch build myself, but I know how to what I'm going to do, and it's already built in. So have fun watching the factory.
Okay.